I live right next door to the cathedral rector. And if you're ever over there, and the sisters let you peek into my room, one of the things you notice is I have lots of photographs surrounding me. I have photographs of my long deceased now mom and dad. I have photographs of my sister and her family and her kids' kids. I have photographs of the priests that trained me how to be a priest back in the day. Photographs of classmates. And I like being surrounded by them. It reminds me, those photos, of the people that I love or have done a lot in my life. If you go over to my office in the pastoral center, there's even more. I have lots of photos of the missionaries of charity. I have photos of events like this, things that have gone on in my 17th year here. And those photos remind me of events and folks that I have gotten to know and love. It means a lot to me if I'm answering my mail, meeting somebody, to have the faces of the people that mean a lot to me looking at me through those photos. And Julie, who's got her camera over here, she photographs almost everything, and it's on the Diocese website. And if I don't want to do my work or feel nothing on TV, I'll go on the website sometimes. Look back at past ordinations or different events that I kind of relive. Those images remind me often of what is important and valuable and how I am connected with some people. And I'm sure you folks, it's the same way. Pictures of grandchildren, grandma and grandpa, brothers and sisters, sports events. Lots of photos that remind us about what we care about. But you know, the real thing is a lot more important than any photo. To actually be with the people you love means more than looking at a video or looking something up on the internet. To be truly in the presence, connected with the people you love means just about everything. I think that is why God, through His Son Jesus Christ, gave us the Eucharist. On the night before the Lord died for us, He gave us the sacrament of His body and blood so that we would never feel separated from Him, for alone or without His loving presence. This is not just a sign. But it is a sign that makes present the one who is signified, the one who is presented. When we receive Holy Communion, we truly are in communion with the body and the blood, the soul and the divinity of our risen Savior. So we never need to be away from Him. We can come into church and get ourselves ready receive Holy Communion by listening to God's Word. When we receive the sacrament, we can tell the Lord that we love Him, that we thank Him for loving us first, that we worship Him because He's truly God, and that we really depend upon Him because also in Christ shared in our humanity. And another miracle happens besides bread and wine becoming the body and blood of Christ. We actually ourselves become a part of what we receive. We deepen our relationship with Jesus so we carry Him more than ever before in our hearts and souls. Getting ready for communion in an essential way is what baptism is all about. We are baptized into a community that gathers around the table of the Lord. When we are confirmed, we receive those gifts of the Holy Spirit that empower us to actually live Christ's life. And it is the Holy Spirit that makes the Mass happen. It is the Holy Spirit, the words of Jesus, that make the miracles sacrament or his body or something we live every day here on this earth, that our lives revolve around that sacrament. Then let us look forward, truly a heaven that is so good, so wonderful, so splendid.